So the real question for today's video is, which hat should we wear today?
I think we're gonna go with the classic Ash Ketchum today. Realistically, it goes backwards anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But welcome back, everybody, to a brand new episode of Pokemon Go. Today, we're gonna be testing out the Pokemon Go Plus once again. I had a little bit of a run with the Pokemon Go Plus last night after I did the video yesterday, and it seemed to be pretty good, although I noticed a lot that it would just always be fled Pokemon, and the Pokemon that you did catch seemed to be very bad. But it was an easy way for you to track your kilometers because it always keeps the eggs tracking. And even though we were driving, it was still putting kilometers on the eggs, and we nearly have the 10k egg ready to go. So anyway, we're gonna test this thing out again today. We're gonna go out to Southport, which is a place nearby. It has pretty good Pokestops, pretty good Pokemon, and we'll see if we can get maybe one Pokemon off the Pokedex today. I just wanna do a lot of testing with this bad boy and just see a couple things like lucky eggs and see if it does double XP. And if it is separate Pokemon, because one thing I was testing was to see if the Pokemon that you catch with this are Pokemon that you can get inside your game, because I noticed that incense Pokemon would not pop up on this. So it's gonna be interesting. Let's see how we go. And also, there's a little bit of a side note, I am very, very sick this morning. It's not like throat sickness, it's just like a cold where I just feel really bad throughout my whole body. Yeah, it doesn't sound good. But Taylor had to wake me out of bed, and he did it by not so casual ways.
He decided to throw all of my bedding around until I got out of my bed. And now I have to make my bed. Why'd you do that, Tay?
Bruh, you made him out of bed.
Yeah, that's bullying. That is absolutely just bullying.
You know what's bullying?
You're making my bed.
Wasting my time is bullying. So.
He's gonna make my bed after.
You know your Pokemon goals when your hat matches your watch and your shoes. It's all matching here.
Okay, so the plan for today, because I'm sick and Taylor is also sick as well. Look at him, he's cleaning out his nose. So we're gonna go hit a juice bar or something just to get some nice healthy juices, vitamins, all that. Just get that going, clean out our system, all that jazz. And I'm gonna set up my Pokemon Go watch, Pokemon Go Plus. Gonna set that up and see what we get. I'll give you guys an update when we get there. And I wanna do like these mini like 10 Pokemon court kind of things where like I catch 5 Pokemon and you don't get to see what it is. Yeah, we'll see what we get in the 10, how far out is it? 10, 20 minutes to the juice bar.
20 minutes.
Here we go.
So like I said yesterday, I was using the Pokemon Go Plus quite a bit, and we got some eggs. We got all 8 of the other eggs. Let's see what we got. 2K, 5K, 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 2K, 5K, and one 10K. So one 10K, that's not too bad. I'm gonna chuck all these bad boys into incubators right now, but 1Ks for the next 10K eggs, that's definitely gonna hatch today. We need to make sure we keep tabs on that, because that's gonna be very, very exciting when that actually does hatch. Now, I wonder what happens if it hatches while we got the Pokemon Go Plus on, so that's gonna be quite interesting. I don't know how that works. I mean, if it does like a weird yellow beep or something, because I know yellow beep's like the only one I haven't seen yet, and that's for a new Pokemon that you haven't caught, which obviously we've got 12 left. The odds of, you know, finding that are pretty rare. So I'm gonna chuck all these bad boys into incubators, and hopefully we get a lot of, you know, eggs hatching today. All right, so we've been driving around for around 20 minutes, and there's a little bit of a reoccurring theme here. Lots and lots of Pokemon fleeing away, which is a little bit disappointing, but some good loot from Pokestops. We'll check to see what we got in a minute, but we got all the eggs, so that doesn't really matter. We got a couple caught Pokemon though, so we're gonna check those out. I think we got like, let's count them. Even then, we still caught 14 Pokemon. I just counted it out. Now I'm pretty sure we probably got maybe double that in fleeing Pokemon, so I'd say roughly 14 caught Pokemon, 30 fled Pokemon. So let's go check them out real quick. See, I'm actually genuinely interested because the egg should have hatched. We definitely did 1K, so let's see if it already hatched. And if so, it will be in our party somewhere. Let's have a look. No, it didn't actually hatch. It didn't get much at all, only like 100 meters. Looks like we were driving too fast in most places. But let's have a look. 14 Pokemon, what do we get? Nidoran, Magikarp, Weedle, Psyduck, Bellsprout, Voltorb, Cubone, Voltorb, okay. There's nothing really crazy there, but it's 14 Pokemon that I didn't have to do anything for except press a button, so I'll take it. So let's have a look at all the Pokemon that we missed. We missed a Goldeen, a Geodude, a Kangaskhan, another Kangaskhan, so there's a couple of Kangaskhans that got away from us. It's actually pretty cool that it shows you what ran away. Oh, Exeggut, I could have used that one, dang it. Eevee ran away, another Eevee ran away. It was pretty good CP as well. Oh no, this sucks, man, seeing all the Pokemon that we missed. Oh, feels bad. Okay, it only goes down to Psyduck, so that's not too bad. Alright, so here we go. We got a fresh orange, apple, pineapple, daily squeeze, cold press. Hopefully this will curve the sickness just a little bit. So we've just rocked up to Southport and we got a triple lure down. So we're gonna go test this out with the Pokemon Go Plus and see how it works with the screen on at the same time.
All right, so we've rocked up here. We've been here for about, I don't know, 10, 20 minutes. And I've noticed a couple things with the Pokemon Go Plus. It seems to not work for incense Pokemon. And as soon as you get into a battle, so I'm just gonna get into this Tentacool. It seems to disconnect your Pokemon Go Plus like straight away. So I'm gonna just run away from it. And there you go, see, it disconnects like that. So I'm gonna reconnect it right there. So yeah, doing that, it's meant to be like from off like actual phone gameplay, but if you walk around for a bit, you'll actually realize that Pokemon that are wild, that aren't from lures it seems, will also be registered on here and you can just press it to catch them. But the problem is that once you try to catch it, it flees away for good. You only get one shot and it flees. So if you don't catch it the first one, it's gone, you can't see it, it disappears from your map as well. So it's probably not good if you find a wild Dragonite to try and catch on your Pokemon Go Plus. Because I don't know what they use for this. I think it's just a regular Pokeball. Don't really know. But either way, we've only got a couple more kilometers for this. Yeah, 200 meters until we've got a 10k egg. So hoping for either Lapras, Onix, and I think that's about it. We'll take a Dratini as well for the candies because we really have our own Dragonite as well. Also, one guy I was chatting to over here said that there was two Snorlaxes that spawned this morning and a Lapras. So, we're going to be keeping our eyes out on the radar. Let me just check it right now. And it seems there's only a Machop right now, but that's actually good because we need to work up that Machamp. So I'm probably going to head over there and get that. But I'm also going to, at the same time, let's walk and vlog and see if we can get on screen for it to come up and show you what happens when you go past the Pokestop with the Pokemon Go Plus attack. Now it's going up with the Pokestop. All right, let's do the egg first. This is it, 10K egg. I wanted to show off the other thing, but this is it, 10Ks. Come on, what's it gonna be? Electabuzz.
Bruh.
That's so disappointing. Not happy with that at all, but this is how it shows up. It says Pokestop nearby. See how that's got that little thing indicating that I can claim it by just pressing this. So instead of it, you know, going in and spinning it, just go ahead, click that, and it'll automatically claim it. There we go, and we got two Pokeballs and a Raspberry. Now let's see if we can do it with a wild Pokemon as well. Alright, let's see, what are you doing, what are you doing? Oh!
Nailed it.
Yeah, I can always like, I always try to do a tail whip, but I can never do it. Can I have a go doing a tail whip?
Okay.
Alright, wait, hold that. This is gonna not go out. Wait up, so it's like, oh, like that, and then, okay. Alright, so it says we caught a Pokemon and we were just chilling there on the scooters, let's see what we got. And it was a Magikarp. I mean, I'll take it, whatever, it's a Magikarp. There's a Magikarp here as well, but it's gone now anyway. So yeah, we're gonna go to this side and see if we can get a Pokemon to pop up just to show what that looks like and, you know, see it disappear and see if we catch it or whatnot. I've never seen it on the screen yet, so this should be interesting. Okay, so Pikachu just got another candy and that is actually, I believe, his 10th candy. So, he's not sitting on my shoulder. Oh, there he is, he's sitting on my shoulder now. He wasn't there and now he is. So that's the Easter egg with Pikachu. Finally got it working and now he's sitting right here on my shoulder. So cool, I know. There's a couple of Pokemon that are also on your shoulder. I think Spearow, Weedle, Caterpie, Pidgey, and Eevee will also sit on your shoulder by default. But Pikachu, you have to walk 10Ks to actually get him to sit on your Pikachu. It looks pretty cool when you're Team Instinct as well, because it's like yellow, yellow, and yellow. So, okay, so it looks like it actually does work with lure Pokemon, just not incense Pokemon. So we're in range to catch this Ponyta. Let's see how it works. I've gone ahead, I've done it. And let's see if it'll catch. There's one bounce, two bounce, three bounce. I think we caught him. Yep, Ponyta was caught. That's so cool. I've never seen it like that before. So I guess it just doesn't work with incense Pokemon. Hopefully that actually gets patched soon. But I wonder if the catch rates are better than actually trying to catch yourself. Let's see what CP that Ponyta was. He was 785. That's a pretty hard catch. Might be the new meta. This is a cool thing. I got eggs hatching, but I can also catch Pokemon with this at the same time. Sick. Two kilometer eggs. You know what we want. Just Charmander or Squirtle. Anything else is just like garbage at this point. Geodude, look, you know what? That's not too bad because now I can get that gravel up to a decent amount before I evolve into a Golem, which we might do in today's episode, I'm not too sure. And then the other second kilometer egg, let's see what we get here. And a Rattata. Great. And yeah, this is like this local like water park. It looks so sick. I'm tempted to get in there, but at the same time, I don't really want to get wet. That was so much fun.
Far out. There's two lifeguards out there. There's three lifeguards out there.
Okay, so we're just trying out a new theory here, because when you fail, it disappears, right? So we got a Cubone right here. I'm gonna try and put this up. It has to fail for this to work, but as soon as it goes red, I'm gonna try and battle it. Oh, it gets an error. Okay, you can't exploit it. I was like,
try and get the error on your Pokemon Go Plus, and then try to battle if it fails anyway, but it gives you an error. I think maybe if you're quick enough, you might be able to get that to work. It's interesting though. All right, so that's gonna do for Southport today. We're gonna go home. We're gonna time ourselves, because it's like a 10, 20 minute drive home. We're gonna time ourselves, see how many Pokemon we can get and see the flea catch rate, kind of see what we're working with, see how we catch, obviously, and yeah, see how we go.
Alrighty, we are back, and we were pretty lucky on the way back home. On a 25 minute car ride, we got quite a lot of Pokemon indeed. I can't even work out how many were fled, but it seems to be like 50-50 for the most part. There's a bad patch right there, but coming up should be like a pretty good... Oh, there's another bad patch of fled. Actually, it's probably... Look at that! Look at this one right here. There was four Pokemon in a row. Wait, that's five. Five Pokemon in a row. That's crazy. So around 10 Pokemon in total. Let's have a look, see what we got. I'm gonna laugh. I open this up and there's just like a Dragonite there. That'd be hilarious. Alrighty, recent, and here's what we got. Oh, okay, it's not too bad here. We got an Abra. A Dratini. That's pretty sick. A Pinsir, and I think that is about where it stops. Yeah, that's, yeah, Electabuzz, and we caught those at the park. So there we go. Dratini, Abra, and a bunch of other pretty cool Pokemon. That's not too bad.
So in conclusion, I would say that the Pokemon Go Plus is very good for car driving. I caught 14 Pokemon there and about 10, 15 on the way back. And all I did was just press the button while driving. So definitely very efficient for that kind of stuff. As far as in the park when you're sitting down, not really that great. I'm not too sure if the catch rates are better on the Plus. I think it would be better to, if you've got a rare Pokemon, just go ahead and try and catch it manually instead of, you know, risking it with this thing. But so that's going to do it for today's episode. Hope you guys did go and enjoy it. If you guys did, let me know, like, rating down below. And I'll catch you guys tomorrow for another exciting episode of Pokemon Go. Later, guys.
So the real question to start today's adventure is Wit Hat. Wit hat?
Wit hat, wit hat, wit hat, wit hat, wit hat.